All right, guys, welcome back. Here we got an A bracket matchup. We got Steve Boucher and Kevin Karen. So this is the flighted nine ball tournament put on by the Players Club. We're at Hillsboro Billiards. The format of this tournament is rack your own nine ball. Nine does not count in the racking pockets. Alternate break, rack your own. Jump cues are allowed. Push out after the break. No three foul rule. Looks like Steve won the flip. He's breaking first. This is a race to seven. Steve setting up for the break. Let's see what he does. Okay, he just kind of bars it in there, makes a couple of balls, makes the one in the cross side. He's got to look at the two, but no real great shot, especially to get on the three, but I think he's going to cut this in the lower right pocket. As we look, the cue ball will go between the five and nine and get a shot in the three. Maybe in the same pocket, or it may shorten the angle to come across and play the three in the opposite corner if he wants to be that aggressive. Or he could play it safe and just kind of nip off the two and put the cue ball down table. All right, he tried my first shot there, just to kind of get loose. This is actually my first time watching Kevin play, so I can't try and guess at all what he might do. He also has a nice safe where he can just nip off the two and tuck the two behind the seven. Just make sure he gets a rail and then leave the cue ball kind of with the seven as a blocker. I think there is an aggressive shot here is to play the seven in the side, but it's kind of a little bit of a back cut on the two. Do I have to kind of back cut the seven? It's pretty close to the hole, but on the video, on the monitor rather, it looks a little better than what it looks like on the table. Let's see what he decides. Oh, he played the cross bank. Got a good shot. I don't think he was expecting to rub off the seven, because obviously now he's got a goofy look at the three ball. This ball cuts on the side, but you get nowhere on the four that way. Kind of the same deal if you bank it cross side. Let's see. I wonder if he might just split it, kind of bank it wide, and maybe hit a two rails up by the four and put the cue ball back by the six, if he can do that. Oh no, he just went that way. He's brought the three back this way and went up table. He left a lot of distance. I think Steve might have an edge here. The problem with this edge, if it's the good edge, then he gets natural shape on the four ball. Yeah, expect Steve to get out from here. He had a really good angle on the five. Same thing with this ball. I think I would have gave him when he got on the seven from there. But that's all right. Steve takes the first rank, holds his serve. I don't get to look at Kevin's break. On the table next to us here, we have Mike Brugier. I cannot remember the name of the guy he's playing, but if you're scrolling through the videos on YouTube, or if you are watching our stream, the August 22nd, you would have saw him play Jason Klatt, the professional player from around the Bloomington, Illinois area. He came down to play in our open nine ball tournament. Curious to see how he does today. So Kevin's break was, he spread him out real good, got a good solid hit. The nine really kind of went flying, and I don't think the six has got him. So he's pretty close to straight on this one ball, but as long as he doesn't glance off the nine and go in the pocket, he'll have a shot on the two. Well, he just stops right there, he's okay. Look for him to cut this ball down the rail. The three balls just are in the pocket to his right. Oh, he banked it. He did not actually intend to bank it, but that's what happened. That was a surprising miscalculation. Speaking of banks, Steve has one, and it comes with position on the three if he wants it. He might be, he might be looking at the carom here. Yeah, no, he just played the bank, ensured himself of a shot on the three, and tried to play a little two-way shot there. I think he hit a little harder than he had wanted. Hoping to kind of get safe if he did bank it wide. Good shot from Kevin. Now he's got another long, pretty straight shot on the three. Going to do something with the cue ball here to get the four. I don't know if it passes the seven. He's looking at it now. I think he's got three quarters of a pocket, so. Yep. Hit that ball nicely. Good speed. With that much force, I wasn't sure he was going to have a good shot on the six, but. Yep. Just kind of stunned into the rail and back out for a nice shot on the seven, not straight in. Get an angle to come two rails for the nine, and is what I expect. Corner as he goes, and straight in. Kevin holds his serve. Got a nice match going on here. looking around the room. I'm trying to see some of the other players going on. We have Dennis Bullock in here. Do believe Ray Menard is here. I thought I saw him earlier. Kurt Kurtz, Joe Evola. Our B flight is the largest flight today. So it looks like Steve broke dry, which is unfortunate because he's got a great look at the rest of the table. The two passes the eight. He's just a little straight on the one, but Kevin shoots hard, so kind of expect him to do the same shot he did on that six ball before, just kind of stun it into the rail and back out for some kind of shot on the two. I think that the three should pass the four. I mean, the four is more of a visual blocker, I think, than an actual blocker, but... But once he solves that... So one, two, three... See what he looks. Looks like he's going forward. I wonder if he was thinking about playing shape for the 2-9. He might still be shooting it. I don't like trying to back cut this ball. Oh, wow. That was a great shot. He banked that ball through traffic, controlled the cue ball, and he's got a great shot on the three, which leads to the four. Now he's just looking to see where he wants to be to get back down table for the five, or at least get to the center of the table, maybe left of center as we look. Three rails forward here. Well, a lot of our table players will just kind of shoot this five in and shoot the six in the top right corner. That might be, I mean, that's the simplest route. Let's see if he wants to kind of move it around a little bit and shoot the six in the same pocket. A lot of player preference goes into this type of shot. Yep, he went forward and got right there. Look at a nice little angle. He can just stop it and maybe slide over to the towards the center a couple inches. Straight here, but he can be all right. He can go forward or around. Yep, like that. Kevin gets two. A dry break is going to cost Steve a little bit. With this being an alternate break, the most it could really cost him is two. Obviously, this one, and then if Kevin breaks and runs the next. Then it would have cost him two games. But Kevin breaks, Steve serve, and they're still just trading racks back and forth. Thank you. he hammers them good. Doesn't make anything. The 3-4 is kind of tied up. The one ball is kind of blocked. Steve might jump, or he might just go ahead and roll out. Or I can't tell if he can get around between the 4 and the side pocket enough to kind of 2-rail kick at it, or one rail, however he likes. Excuse me. Now Steve called a push. Question is, where do you push? Where do you push so that the guy doesn't lock you up when you come back to the table? He's just going to leave some distance. Yeah, just give him an edge, kind of tease him a little bit. Say there's an edge for you to cut, or you could try to bank it by the 5. He might have enough of the ball to just kind of bank it a little wide of the 5 and put the cue ball under the 2, or rather on top of the 2. Let's see what he does. Yeah, he gave it back. He didn't like it. So let's see what Steve had in mind. Oh, he could see all of that ball to go off that side. That was the idea, but Steve had too much of the one ball. And he just wanted to move the one ball a little bit behind the 2 and obviously have the cue ball all the way back down here. And Kevin was trying to get around the 2 ball there and clip the back side of it, so now he's got an awkward shot. This ball does bank, and I think if he can miss the kiss, he'll have something on the 3. But there's a pretty good save too, where he can just kind of glance off and put the cue ball around the 6-9, maybe get under the 3-4. Kind of like this. Or maybe get right under the 9. That'll work. Steve's got he's got this ball rail first. He's certainly got it rail first. I can't tell if he can actually just get straight to it. Going rail first is going to be tough to get any kind of look at the 3, any kind of good look at the 3. That's where he's going to end up, is right where he is now. Makes it tough. Yep, he's just going to float on over there. A long shot on the 3, glance off the 4, and probably hit the 5 with the cue ball. Where's the 4 going to go after that? No, if he misses the 4, the cue ball might actually come under the 5, you know, right off the rail between the 7 and the pocket. Oh, he's jacking up. Okay, he specifically played to hit the 5 to take that angle out of the equation. Well, you jack up and complicates the shot, makes it tough. Kevin's got an awkward back cut here. He's going really close to that pocket. Yeah, tried to over... Oh, he did overcut it. Ball wiped its feet on its way down, but he stayed out of the scratch. Now the 5 ball's really blocked. He cannot get to the 5 off the bottom rail, even if he gets there. So he's going to have to do something with the 5. Now, in theory, oh my, I think he's just gonna play safe, bank the 4 back up table, put the cue ball right in between the 5-7, if that's what he's looking at. If he wants to be ultra aggressive, you could play the 4 off the top of the 5, the 5 banks up table. Then you have to worry about getting hooked on the on the 5 by the 6, unless the 5 actually goes. But I think he's playing safe. And unless he's actually looking at the 4-9. Okay, yeah, he tried to really kill that ball into the side rail and have it slide under and, you know, kind of nip into the 7, but I think he needed a little more outside spin to kill that ball off the first rail. So now he's got a very awkward shot. I kind of half expect him to kick into the long rail and push the 5 under the 7 and just try and leave the balls all tied up there like this. But he actually left it. The 5 passes from now, it does. He needed a little more juice on that ball. I'm not sure if Steve can hold this for the 6 on the side. He might just go, oh, he can. He might get any Steve. Good shot. Cut this in, go right back to about center table. Yeah, right to where he was. Yeah, probably draw straight down the long rail here. Oh, he wanted to just pound it and come across. That works too. Kind of let your stroke out a little bit. In a more controlled manner. He cuts that ball with inside English and he breaks Kevin's serve. Steve hasn't quite figured out the break on this table yet. Steve's primary room is a room filled with diamond tables, so it's a little bit different. What, you know, the speed and the angle that works on a diamond doesn't always work on a valley. Spy. I don't think he can make this on the side. He's gonna just clip it and play safe. Under the 6-7. Nice. Steve's got an interesting kick shot to calculate out here. I'm not sure the normal 2 rail is available. He might have to kick to the short rail, then the long rail, then the short rail. Go 3 rails at it from this angle. Try and hit the 2. That 4 ball, the 4 ball and the 8 ball are just in the worst possible positions to kick towards the bottom of the table first. He's gonna try and kind of maybe, can get around the 7 enough to hit the long rail, then maybe go right at the 2. No, he's just going to tie up a ball. No 3-foul rule, no sense in firing something that you're not sure what's going to happen. Play a smart shot, control the foul, and then you're good. So, and Kevin's now figuring out how is he going to deal with that 6-7, that problem that Steve just created. So that was a very, very intelligent foul. This is a smart shot. He decided to go ahead and play safe, use the 2-ball to open the 6 and 7. He really wanted to obviously freeze him on the back of the 3, but that's tough to control. And again, I can't tell if Steve has enough of the 2-ball straight in or if he has to play a rail first shot. I think he's got the edge, but he's queuing, yeah. He really wanted this angle on the 6. Now he's got to go down table and come kind of spin 2 rails back out and get an angle on the 7. Unless he can kind of snap draw it. Or, there you go. The 7 does go in the side. Well, Steve really sees all the angles very well. I like that he doesn't get himself locked into original decisions. I would think that, Kevin gave it up. I would think that his initial plan was to leave an angle on the 6 to come back out to the center of the table, play the 7 in the same pocket. But because of his angle change from the 6, he had to find a new plan. And he found one quickly and executed it. Hit him decently, a lot of power. Not exactly square, but he made a ball. He's got a bank shot on the 1. I don't know if it leads to anything other than a bank shot or a safe on the 2, which might be all you need. Just control the table. You don't always have to try and run out. He's playing safe off the 1. He didn't like it. And played a very good save. Nicely done. That was a good shot. Good speed control. Good angle. Assuming he gets ball in hand, now he can at least, you know, control the angle he's got on the 1 to get down on the 2. The 7 does pass the 8. The 5-6 combo is 99% dead. The 5 goes in the other corner. So this might be the shot that takes the rack. Steve's trying a 2-rail kick. Long rail, long rail. Oh no, he's going this way. He's trying 3-rail short. Oh, just missed it. Wow. And now the five goes in both pockets. The three ball is the issue. But not if you get, well, he's a little on the wrong side of this ball. Maybe he might choose to just try and run into the three right here so he can still shoot it. Yeah, just like that. He did not want that ball to go. And we can see why. He's a mile away from the five ball. It's a thin cut. It's tough to control. Yeah, tough to get shape on afterwards. Alright. Gervin's biting hard. And he still didn't leave. I mean, this isn't like ball and hand shape on the five or anything. Didn't do anything fancy with the six. Just made sure he made the ball. And as long as he made it, he'll have a shot at the eight. That was a nice little bump he got off the nine here. Yeah. Steve's going to take a two-game lead now. Steve passed the halfway point. Kevin's got his work cut out for him. Some action going on the 9-footers down here. We got two 9-foot diamonds and a 9-foot bar box. I also have a 9-foot gold crown. All right, Steve's changing sides. And he lost the cue ball. Steve's going to have to figure out this break. I dare say this is quite uncharacteristic. The last time he was here, he was breaking very well. You know, and being and able to adjust, you know, to the way the table changes over the course of the day. Nice shot from Kevin. Hit that ball with a little inside to, hold his angle on the three, but I think also because if he happened to clip the nine with that spin, it would actually throw it towards the pocket a little bit. Another good shot. Jacked up draw shot. And he's kind of going away from the five if he puts that in the corner, so he's looking at the side pocket because that'll leave him the angle he wants on the five to play it in that corner. Ooh, risky shot, but good read on the angles. He mishits that ball by a quarter inch. He's in the drink, and another rack goes to Steve, but he hit it just perfect. A lot of players might have tried to draw that ball back to have a what would be considered maybe an easier shot in the seven. The problem with drawing that ball back is that you don't get angle on the 8. From the 7 from there. So he left himself a good angle. He kind of overjuiced that ball a little bit. And he's on the rail. That's a tough shot to get on the 9. He's just going to go back and forth, leave himself a long shot, get on the right side of the ball. And he takes a wreck. Kevin kind of wrecked himself there a little bit. 2-9's all tied up, doesn't go anywhere. This is kind of a messy little table here. This is. And he's long, jacked up, and straight in. See what his plan was for this. He might just graze off with what is the left side of the 2. And use the 7-4-3 as blockers, and the 2 will slide over straight across the table. He might have another idea for a safety, but let's see. Nope. Yep. There we go. I think that where the 3 is now, he can get in there and open up that 4-7. Spun that ball to get there, but he needed more angle off the first rail. So now he's just going to pick his spot on the 3 and then figure out how to get there from the 2. Now if he moves the 4 over to the side rail, it doesn't really go by the 5, so curious if, see what happens. I guess he's going to play it. Okay. It looked like to me like the 7 was going to go a little high, but he's on the right side of it. Isn't that good? Yep, that ball throws it. Good shot. A lot of players would have played that 5 in that corner that is closest to instead of just kind of letting it out. But then you're going to end up real close to the 6. Closer than what he is now. Steve gets another one, goes to 5. Let's see if Steve figured out anything on the break yet. He's been having some trouble making a ball, so he's going back to his original position. Curious to see if he'll use more or less power. That makes a huge difference in how the ball spread. And he hit him with more power, made a ball, and the cue ball. And this is a pretty wide open rack. The you know, the five's kind of a blocker. So the three to the four could be interesting. I think the four to the five, I think he might kind of get straight above the five and then shoot the four in this corner, then float forward under the five, play the five in the sides closest, because that'll lead you to the six. But let's see how he likes to go this route. I think one of the two of the three is just center table, center table, center table. I need to. This is going to be the crucial shot. Is to get where does he get on the three so he has a, the right angle to, on the four. He's a little straight here. It's, he may have to actually draw this back under the five. Unless he can get, maybe he gets, I don't know. We're going to have to wait, use his judgment. Well, he's just going to play safe, I think. Decided he didn't want to force it. Steve's got a look at it. I can't tell how much of a look. He's thinking about the cross bank. It's kind of there, but it's kind of not. Oh, don't scratch. Hmm. Yeah, that angle is obviously that's a tough one. Now, the good news is he didn't leave a great shot. The four does not pass the eight. Kevin just has a sliver. He's just going to leave distance. He hit it about as thin as I've seen anybody hit a ball in a while. It almost came backwards. Now the four does pass the eight, but you got to maneuver the cue ball to get some to get shape on the five. Although, even if he hits it slow, he just has to worry about the nine. Whoa. That was unexpected. I feel like he just kind of got down and shot it. It looked a little rushed. Good controlled shot from Kevin there. Play the bank. Get the cue ball on an angle for the five. There's another speed sensitive shot here. Well done. Use the inside English with the second rail to burn off some of that speed. Knowing that once you hit the second rail, you're in line the whole way, as long as you don't get behind the nine. And there, his speed got away from him a little bit, but it won't be a problem. And Kevin crawling back. 5-4. Race to 7. Kevin changed sides on the break. I'm not sure how much more successful he was there either. He hit a little off center. He's got a kind of a little rail first slight masse shot if he wants it. Well, he's just going to clip it and come on down. Steve stepped away for a moment.
For what we're doing.